we're going to give our Muslim brothers and sisters a few minutes to finish their Magda prayer, right? So let's keep up these chants. Let's keep the visuals great for the press that are here about our unified message to support all immigrant New Yorkers, especially our Muslim and refugee brothers and sisters, right? Thank you. Thank you. And let's keep hearing those amazing chants, y'all. Let's get ready. It's going to be a long 3 years ahead of us, right?
To also convey my gratitude to all those who came tonight. I know I said that, but you can't overemphasize the amount of appreciation that CAIR New York feels towards every single one of you for coming out and showing what it is that solidarity means and to showing how it works. You know, we say a lot that New York City is a beacon of light to the world, and we do often get calls from as far as South Africa, from Japan and Korea, from all over the Middle East. And they say that they see New York as the example. And that example lies with you, your compassion. It lies with you, your dedication to social justice. It lies with you, with your decision tonight and every single day hereafter to say, I will not be silent and I will not stay boarded up within four walls. I will hit the streets and I will support my brothers and sisters because an injustice to one is an injustice to all. Now I have a request of every single one of you. Let me hear you say, united we stand.
United we stand.
Intolerance will fall.
Intolerance will fall.
And light will prevail.
And light will prevail.
Our work with the Council on American-Islamic Relations here with the New York chapter is a civil rights organization, and we are dedicated to your civil rights. Muslim Americans have been attacked over and over and over again, but you know what? We're resilient and we are strong, and we will come back with more and more advocacy, more and more challenges, more and more protests, whatever it takes to make sure that there is justice for all with the Muslim American community, with our undocumented people here in New York and elsewhere, with immigrants all over, and with anyone who is vulnerable. CAIR New York is here, and we will always stand up for civil rights because that is what America is supposed to be. That is what it is with every single one of us. See why we're proud New Yorkers. Issues that are being brought to light, I just want to emphasize right now, because you know what? This is not an issue for one community only. This is not about being colored or not colored. This is not about being Muslim or being of a different faith. This is not about being a particular gender. This is not about identifying yourself in any one box that they hope you to identify yourself with. We are the face of humanity. We are the face of compassion. And we are the face of strength that will always speak up when there is an injustice. One thing that I'd really like to point to, what he said, and I firmly believe. After Trump won, various media outlets and community leaders and so on, we were being asked, what is the sentiment? And you know, there's an Islamic principle that I'd like to share with you all in the scripture, the Quran, which is the holy book of Muslims. And it says that sometimes what we believe is good for us turns out not to be good for us. And what we believe to be bad for us ends up being a blessing. And this is the blessing that this president has brought to us. This awakening, this solidarity, this acknowledgement that as different people, we are here on this earth to get to know each other, to love each other, and to fight for one another. That is our calling, and it starts here. You have to understand what it means to be a sanctuary city. It means that we have people like yourselves who are willing to speak up for others who cannot speak themselves. So make sure your voices are heard tonight, loudly, and every night. that is repeated over and over again, and that is, do good to thy neighbor as you would want done to yourself. Does that concept not still live in America? So as each and every single American does a little bit of soul searching and comes to grips of what they want for their nation, every single one of us, including myself, must ask, do I love my neighbor the way I love myself? Do I want for my brother or sister what I want for myself? Do their children, are those the faces that those faces that I see, do I also see the faces of my own children? And the answer for every single one of us is yes. That is what we're here about today, to make sure that that love is felt throughout the city and nation. Because we are bigger than hate, and love will always, at the end, coupled with action, triumph over Trump. New York City, as been said over and over and over again by every single one of these wonderful speakers, is a city built on immigrants. This nation is a nation built on immigrants. The Statue of Liberty calls on to those who are desperate and despondent, and it is New York that has historically opened up its arms. As every single one of us has come through various channels, whether it's Ellis Island, before that or after that, we are a city of immigrants, and we will resist because we must resist. And we will resist against injustice. Yeah. With every fiber of our being and with every strategy at our disposal. You know, we are so blessed to be in New York City, where we do have an administration that is willing to stand up for the rights of our undocumented, the rights of our immigrants, the rights of our minorities. And we have to make sure that every elected official is on point with this. Because what some people don't get on the federal level and elsewhere is that all elected officials are servants of the public. Now we turn to those activists that are on the streets all the time, various organizations. Organizations that take it to the streets, organizations that challenge things in courts, organizations that are those that press forward with momentum and an undying courage to voice what needs to be heard against those that need to hear it. Because sometimes a single individual cannot voice what a collective organization can, and they serve you without any self-willed, self-interest. No, their interest is your interest.
I want to give a quick shout out. We have protesters marching into our space that we're here to talk about water is life. So